Good morning, everybody. Honorable Commissioner Sir, on behalf of Audit 3 Commissionerate, हम अभी का आप सभी का हार्दिक स्वागत करते हैं. जैसे कि आपको अपने डिपार्टमेंट के बारे में बहुत सारी जानकारी या दी जाएगी. इस कार्यक्रम के अवसर पर सबसे पहले मैं आदरणीय सुपरिटेंडेंट नाइक जी से विनती करता हूं कि हमारे रिस्पेक्टेड कमिश्नर को पुष्प गुच्छ प्रदान करके हम उनका सम्मान करेंगे. थैंक यू सर. आज यहाँ इकट्ठे हुए सभी न्यूली रिक्रूटेड इंस्पेक्टर का वंस अगेन मैं हार्दिक स्वागत करता हूँ, उनको बधाई देता हूँ. कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत करने के पहले एक चीज बताने देना चाहता हूँ कि आज आप सब यूनिफॉर्म ऑफिसर्स हैं. हमको ये यूनिफॉर्म इसलिए दी जाती है कि जैसे कि पुलिस चोर को पकड़ती है क्योंकि वो चोरी करता है, हम भी पुलिस है और देश की चोरी कोई इकोनॉमिकली करता है, कोई फ्रॉड करता है तो उसे हम पकड़ते हैं. इस बारे में नासेन द्वारा अलग अलग विषयों पर आपको ट्रेनिंग दी जाएगी, इसे मैं शुभ अवसर ही समझता हूं. मैं ऑनरेबल कमिश्नर सर से विनती करता हूं कि सर इन नए रिक्रूट ऑफिसर को आप बधाई एवं उनके भविष्य के लिए मार्गदर्शन किया जाए. धन्यवाद सर.
धन्यवाद दिग्गज जी एंड ऑल आवर कोलीग्स. I welcome on behalf of Audit 3 all of the newly recruited inspectors. I suppose that all of you have already undergone training during the last month or so. So first of all, if I get a feedback from you that over the months have you understood that the service which you have joined, what is the brief for you, what exactly are the nature of your duties and what are your rights? So if you say yes, you have understood, then accordingly I can formulate my introduction or my message to you. So may I get some feedback from some of you at least?
Good morning, sir. My name is Sachin Doji and as far as you asked about feedback, we have been trained under, we have been taught various laws, PSCs, Central Excise, Service Tax also, so that we can understand the legacy issues that come forward. And if I talk about audit specifically, so we have been taught about the sections under which the audit takes place, types of audits and what we actually have to see under audit. Our major tasks have been, what we have to monitor is generally the implementation of the GST law, so that we can keep an eye on all the trades, so that no one evades taxes. Whatever taxes are to be paid are paid and duly on time. So that is brief of what.
Anyone? It is clear that most of you have already had some preliminary overview of the department, of the act and rules under which we are operating, and what are our comparative powers and responsibilities. As far as audit is concerned, generally for a new officer at any level, whether it is an inspector, whether it is a superintendent or assistant commissioner, at any level, audit is a subsequent event. Means, first of all, our hierarchy, our formation of the department is also like that, that it starts with a range, then above the range there is a division, and above the division there is a commissionerate. Then commissionerates are grouped into zones, and the country is divided into zones. So whenever a new officer joins, at whatever level, his first exposure is in the range, where the basic work, like a taxpayer first takes a registration in the range. And from in the range, he files all his returns. The range officer can check his returns. And his refund also is generated or is sanctioned at the range level. Since a division is headed by a group A officer, and generally five ranges are within one division, sometimes in a bigger division it can be six, seven ranges also. So once you are exposed to what are the work of an inspector in the range, and then after spending a few years, you are generally posted to audit. Because audit is a much complex task. It encompasses all the activities of a taxpayer. Even his declarations before the income tax authorities, his declarations before the registrar of companies, all these, his declarations, his documents, his books of accounts, everything you have to check in audit, which may not be possible in the starting years of your career, because it takes some time to understand the basic work. So usually you will be posted to audit only after at least 4 or 5 years of your service in the range or in the division or in the technical side. So now our roles as a uniformed officers have also changed over the period of time. Though we still wear uniforms in Central Excise, GST, and also in customs. But as in customs, it is popularly said that facilitation of trade is more emphasized rather than enforcement. Enforcement is very much a part of our duties, but facilitation of trade. So the same thing applies here also, in GST side also. Central Excise days, we had this Naka Bandis also. On highways or many interior roads also, we had our own checkpoints, excise checkpoints. Like still we have police checkpoints, we have forest checkpoints. Similarly, we used to have excise checkpoints. Over the years, with liberalization, these checkpoints are no more operating. But in GST, since there is a concept of e-way bill, and department has started in a big way checking the trucks and all, but there was resistance from trade. So now the practice is only occasional, only when there is information. Then on information based, you may be put on those places where the goods transport carriers are passing through, and you may check the declarations with respect to the goods that they are carrying. This activity still has importance because there are many malpractices still adopted by the trade. Recently, only in casual conversation in my other group where we have certain sports activities, so one of the owner of a factory was telling me. He didn't realize that I can pass it on to my officers. He said, कि साहब हम लोग तो ट्रक भेज देते हैं खाली और वो जो भाड़ा होता है ट्रक के भाड़े में हमारा 20 लाख का आईटीसी बन जाता है. There are many items which are costly and the credit itself, credit which is 18% of the value of the goods. Suppose the value of the goods in one truck is 1 crore. So 18% is the ITC. The truck which is going, truck is actually passing through the toll naka because in inquiries we will certainly find out whether that particular truck number which is given, it has passed through that toll naka or not, because toll naka will have that record. So truck actually passes, but it doesn't contain anything. In fact, it was a news for me. Ashish ji, aisa hai kuch aapko zyada pata ho. हो जाती है, बट मतलब इस तरह की कुछ प्रैक्टिस कुछ लोग कर रहे हैं, मतलब नॉट ऑल. सो बड़ा वेरी कॉन्फिडेंटली ही जस्ट वी वर कैजुअली डिस्कसिंग एंड ही टोल्ड मी. सो इट वाज अ न्यूज फॉर मी, बट ऑफिसर्स हु आर इन द फील्ड लाइक आशीष गोयल जी विल डिलीवर, ही विल ऑल्सो एड्रेस यू ऑन सर्टेन टॉपिक्स. सो ऑफिसर्स हु आर इन द फील्ड दे हैव more first-hand information. At our level, we do not know what is actually happening in the field. Actually, after this GST was introduced, I was already an additional commissioner, so I never had the opportunity to actually go out in the field and find out whether empty trucks are going. So now I came to know that empty trucks are sent, only a record is created and ITC is taken. So the challenge before you, once you go in the field, will be to identify what are the malpractices which are taking place and how to stop them without actually inviting complaints. What is the most important, that these days, the moment an GST officer or excise officer wants to exercise his powers, there is a resistance from the trade, and general public also, and top authorities also, immediately they will believe if a complaint is received against GST officer. So you have to be very careful whenever you are sent in the field by your supervising officers. Generally you will receive instructions from your superintendent. Sometimes you may receive instructions from the assistant commissioner or deputy commissioner, who is the supervisory head. So there are even powers to arrest is there under our law. It is executed by an inspector only, but power to arrest is a rare power which is exercised in our day-to-day affair. So only the commissioner sanctions the proposal to arrest a person.